God keep you sowing.
Yes, ma'am.
I don't know how I went there, but the Lord just told me to tell that to you. I'll keep you sowing. I'll keep you. I'll make sure you live in a world of abundance.
Yes, sir.
Yes,
Lord.
Yes, Lord.
And when you finish that, I'll go get you some more. Hey, I'll be giving away. Because I got more. God is saying, I got more blessings. Yeah. And you can't give away more than I got.
Yeah.
Yeah. Try to give it away and see if I'll find more.
Amen.
Mm. I'll fill your barrels. Your cruise will never run dry. Your barrels will never be empty.
Yes.
Because you have learned how to be a sower. Let us. Well, thank you, Jesus. Let me go back. Let us provoke. Close it. Let us consider one another. You got a job to do for one another.
Yeah.
You can't afford to be selfish.
Amen.
You can't afford to let this person not see you.
That's right.
Can't wait for you to get this new job.
Amen.
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 I'm ready to shout right now.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Matter of fact, I am going to shout right now. Thank you, Jesus. Because I believe God with you.
Yes,
and I trust God for you.
Yes,
and I can't let you leave this church without me encouraging you in my name. I've got to be here for you. I've got to be here for you. I've got to be here for you. And see, and that's our problem. We so worried about us getting our own blessing that we don't want to be here for somebody else.
That's right. Amen.
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 That's right.
You can't afford to miss a service.
Amen.
That's right.
There's too many lives depending on you being here. Too many people need you. Not just me, Tasha, not just me, but everybody knowing you ain't here.
Yeah.
Everybody knows because we feed on you and you feed on us. Verse 25, forsake not and not forsaking the assembly of ourselves together. As the manner of some is, some people just don't want to be around God's people. How you don't want to be around God's people? Could be evil. How you don't want to be around God's people?
Amen.
I want to see God's glory.
Yes, sir.
I want to see somebody that couldn't walk. I want to see them walk.
Amen.
I want to see a blind man see.
Amen.
I want to see God's glory. I want to take somebody's crutches and hang them on the wall.
Come on.
A wheelchair that somebody used to sit in and don't sit in it no more.
Come on.
Because God!
Yeah.
Yeah. How you think we're going to see that if we can't even be on one accord in this church?
Amen.
You know, I'm tired of church. Church should be the time when we ready to see what God gonna do this time.
Yes.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
I'm declaring, Lord, in 2016, Lord, I'm asking you to do something different every time we come together.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Listen to me, it's important. It's important that you testify. It's important that you tell God's goodness.
Yes.
It's important that you tell the glory of God. Yes. If God bless you, you got a reason and a right to tell how good God has been.
Yes.
Because you don't know what God, what you're going through. Somebody else may have been going through the same thing, and they need you. The Bible says we overcome by our testimony. You need to tell the goodness of the Lord.
Yes.
From now on, I need all testimonies on my desk. I'm not going to let you leave that tell your testimony.
Amen.
God did something for you. Are you quiet about it? Are you serious? I got to see his glory.
Yes. Yes.
Anybody in here with me?
Yes.
I want to see God's glory. It's going to take us. It's going to take us being on one accord. No, get this stuff out of your mind. I'm tired of church. How are you going to be tired of church? Well, that's caps of heaven for you. But ain't nowhere in the world you can go to heaven. Ain't nowhere in the world you can go to heaven. That's right. If you're tired of church, how you gonna go to heaven? How you gonna get God some glory in heaven? You can't even give some glory here. You gonna go through more hell here than heaven. You need more. You need church.
Yes.
Anybody ever came to church and they just felt better?
Yes.
Yes. Anybody that came to the house of the Lord and just a worship, the right worship, did it for you?
Yes.
Built you up?
Yes.
Anybody got into a prayer service, a prayer where it just changed, shifted the whole matter?
Yes.
You was confused, you were broken, you were messed up, but then God did something in that prayer.
Yes.
That's what's needed now. We cannot allow it. We cannot allow situations to determine our praise. I hope I'm brainwashing you right now. You cannot sit home.
Come on.
When folk want to glorify God.
That's right.
Amen.
Can't do it. Because guess what? The second you sit home, the second you miss what God's trying to get you.
Amen.
God said, there go. Here you hear me. I'm gonna fix your child in this service right here. And see, the devil know it too. So he said, girl, you tired. Girl, you so tired. You can't do it today. Ain't no way you can do it today. Your body hurt, your back aching, your legs, your knees, your toes, your hair, all of this. You just messed up. You ain't gonna do it. And the devil telling you that because he knows that there's something about to happen.
Yes, man. Yes.
So I gotta do all that I can to keep her from getting on her post. Y'all remember that saying? The saying said, a sunshine on a dog patting pots one day.
What?
I don't know that one.
No,
that was an old saying.
What does it say? It is.
What you just said?
It is. It is.
saying that says the sunshine will shine on your hind pocket one day. But the problem is, if you ain't there,
don't say hi.
Listen to me. Listen to me. Catch the thought. Don't look at the negative. Look at what I'm really trying to say. I'm trying to say if you're not there, that sun can't hit you.
Amen.
I'm trying to say if you ain't in place, and the problem with us as believers is that we don't know how to be in place. I may have messed up a little.
May shouldn't have said it like that. Y'all pray for me, I'll pray for you.
You don't say everything you supposed to say, we supposed to say.
Come on.
Help me. What I'm trying to tell you is, we got to get this mindset out of our mind that it's okay not to be. Listen, I don't know if y'all know this about me yet, but I'm talking to my church. I'm talking to my church now. Now I'm about to switch and I'm finished preaching. I'm switching. In 2016, God has given me a commission to reach 1,000 souls. I need your help.
Amen.
And I can't use you if you won't be here.
Amen.
We can't operate. We got to operate as a whole team. As a whole team to move forward. I need your help. I need your help, and I need you to understand that when you're not in place, you're messing the whole thing up. I need you in place. I need when a new person come in this church, they've got worshipers beside them. I need that. I need somebody to recognize that we got a new person in there going through something. And this church cannot be dead. On the Sunday, we got somebody that we make it help. That's what I need. I need your help to know that you are important in place. And you cannot afford to miss a service, miss a Bible study, miss prayer. Y'all missing this stuff. And it's good stuff. Man, we went to Reverend Carter's house and literally had, I don't know how to explain it. And this is a man who comes to this church, love. He used to pastor 900 members. This man pastored 900 members at one of the biggest churches in the Eastern Shore. His daughters tried to take him to Courtney Macbeth Church and then take him to Gethsemane Baptist Church, to these big giant churches. He said, no, I want to go to my little church. He believes something is here.
Yes.
And we as believers got to know that we got something here.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Let me tell you something. This ain't no regular church. Yes. We're not regular. We ain't like everybody else.
That's true.
People are getting help to hear. Yes, people are getting delivered here. This young lady gave her heart to God.
Yes.
I'm not here to be phony. I'm here to help you make it to the glory.
Amen.
And it's serious. It's just that serious to me. And I need the whole church to know who you are. I need the whole church to help you when you're down. I need the whole church, because there's little things about me, I got to be real with y'all. The little things about me, I'm learning to be a pastor. I'm only been pastor for 6 years. Amen.
Amen.
I'm learning, so some days I don't do like I'm supposed to do. I don't call like I'm supposed to call. So I need somebody else to pick up my slack and pick up the phone and call you.
That's right.
And say, hey, how you doing?
It's true.
Is everything good? Need anything? I need this. We have to operate like a full ministry because you have a call. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. The Bible.